Welcome to the KJL Art Sanctuary podcast with your host, Kenneth J. Lewis Sr., and we're thrilled to have you tuning in. Each week, we delve into the world of art, speaking with a diverse range of visual artists, sculptors, photographers, and creatives. It's our passion to explore the stories behind the works, the inspiration that drives these talented individuals, and the unique perspectives they bring to the creative process. In today's episode, we have an exciting artist interview lined up for you. We'll be diving deep into their journey, their techniques, and their insights into the world of art. Whether you're an art enthusiast, a fellow creative, or simply curious about the artistic process, we hope you'll enjoy this episode as much as we do. So sit back, relax, and let's embark on this artistic journey together. Welcome to the KJL Art Sanctuary podcast.
Thank you so much for joining us today on KJL Art Sanctuary podcast. I'm your host, Kenneth Lewis Sr. Your support means the world to us. Don't forget to show love by liking, sharing, subscribing, and hitting the notification bell. Your engagement helps us grow and reach more listeners just like you. Together, let's build a vibrant community of art enthusiasts and creatives. Remember, your presence matters in our journey, and we're grateful for every moment you spend with us. Until next time, stay inspired and keep creating. Hey, everybody. This is artist Kenneth Lewis Sr., KJL Art Sanctuary Podcast. I'm excited for today's episode. We have a wonderful artist, Rebecca Eve Swan, and we're so looking forward to talking with her, and I'm going to share with you her bio in a second. And please, everyone, remember to like, share, subscribe my YouTube channel. We're building it. I just hit a whopping 100 subscribers. I'm on my way. But please share. And it really, really helps. I found out that it really takes about a year or more to get even 1,000 subscribers. So not unless you just hit the jackpot on something and a bunch of people subscribe. So I'm not going to try to do anything crazy to get a bunch of subscribers. But anyway, let me read you Rebecca's bio. Rebecca is a New Jersey-based artist. She seeks to add color, wonder, and joy anywhere she can. Rebecca is an illustrator, muralist, clay artist, and a yoga teacher. She believes there is opportunity everywhere to add a spark of whimsy and hope through her colorful, nature-inspired work, no matter the size. Art has always been a part of Rebecca's life, but she never thought it would be a possible career path until she gave herself permission to go for it. Before 2020, Rebecca was a strength and wellness coach for over 12 years and was beginning to get the nudge to pivot despite her love and care for her clients and team. The pandemic compelled her to make the leap from full-time coach to full-time artist. Creating is Rebecca's passion, and it shows through her enthusiastic approach to her work, from collaborating with her clients to sharing progress videos with her audience. Her process and love for her craft is infectious. She uses her art, the process of making and moving meditations, to encourage others to connect with themselves. Art provides a beautiful opportunity to see and feel something that hadn't existed before by offering new perspective. Rebecca is a dream weaver who has the unique ability to take her vision and her clients' ideas and bring them to life through bright, eye-catching colors, whimsical, offbeat creations, and one-of-a-kind compositions. Rebecca knows the power of color and imagination. She strongly believes that adding a sprinkle of playful charm to spaces inside and out cultivates a more magical and supportive community. When our communities feel uplifted, they want to share it, and the enthusiasm it generates with the world. That is beautiful. So you can see why I'm very excited to interview this young lady. And, you know, so without further ado, How you doing, Rebecca? How's everything?
Everything's great. How are you?
Yeah, I'm great. Great. Hey, listen, we want to do a check if anybody's on. You know, people come in and out sometimes, but if anyone's having trouble hearing me, you know, just let me know if you're having trouble. I hear someone. Okay, let's see what we got here. We already got one comment here.
That was.
And here we go. Good morning. How are you? Hey, you know the messages. They're not just saying good morning to me. They're saying it to you too, Rebecca, because they're on here to hear and see what you have to do.
Good morning.
Yes,
good
yes,
morning.
Yes. Okay, I see you got here. A little response. Good morning.
Yay.
Okay, I got another response. Someone saying we can hear you. Let's see. We have Esther Miller on here. We can hear you. I think she put on there. Yep. We have it here. Yes, we can hear you. All right. Cool. Cool. Hey, listen, I'm so excited to have you on here. You know, I met this young lady. I went over to Hamilton, and a friend of mine, Samai Yosef, who I interviewed before, I went over to her. You know what? I keep looking down. I have two cameras on. Let me try to look here and look at you guys. I'm looking down here. So every now and then, forgive me if I'm looking here because I'm looking at two screens. But anyway, so I went to her space, Heart of Art in Hamilton. And Rebecca was there. She was vending. She was selling. Her art was really nice there. So we shared information as artists. I looked at her stuff. She looked at mine. And man, she does some really wonderful work. And you'll see as we go along, she's a very talented artist. And I have a slew of questions to ask her. And I hope she just doesn't mind. But before we start, we always have a quote that the artist likes to live by. So let me pull up Rebecca's quote here. And then she can maybe elaborate a little bit more on that. So let's see here. I'm a little slow right here. You know what? I didn't load it up on here. But I'm trying to see what it is, dude. What are we going to do?
Check your text message.
Oh, if you believe in yourself, anything is possible. Because I meant to put that order. I texted her this morning, like, you know what? I didn't have your artist quote, and I still didn't put it on my script. So go ahead. Like, so what do you mean? If you believe in yourself, anything is possible.
Yeah. What I mean is, for me at least, I have a real knack for getting in my own way. Mm-hmm. And when I believe in myself, and I really believe that this applies to anybody, when you really hone in on trusting your gut and mm-hmm. going forth with that, mm-hmm. you really can make magic happen. I mean, mm-hmm. it's, you are only, mm-hmm. You are your own limit in a certain way, you know? I mean, of course, there's always things, but to a certain mm-hmm. extent, I think we stop ourselves from really living out our fullest potential. And mm-hmm. I'm really trying not to do that. I'm really trying to just believe in myself and believe I can do it. And to be, you know, an example for other people to do that too. And, you know, to changing my career when the pandemic mm-hmm. hit, that's 4 years ago now, but it still feels like this huge leap of faith that I'm taking, you know, to trust the universe that I'm going to be okay. And I'm going to be able to do what I want to do with my life and mm-hmm. help other people live mm-hmm. that magic. You know, I mean, mm-hmm. that's why we're here. That's why we're here on Earth. Like, we're supposed to be living into our potentials. You know, I should do, not what she thinks I should do. You know, like, what do you want to do with your life? And then what steps do we need to take to make that a reality? And mm-hmm. I really try to embody that in my art, in my day to day, and in my yoga classes. You know, I really try to live that mission.
Yeah. And it's so funny because, you know, people, we end up self-sabotaging ourselves. Often, 100%. You know, we talk ourselves and we have dual energy going. So think about this. You could say, I want to be an artist. And you say, I'm going this way. You're going in this direction. And then you say, but it's going to be hard. I don't know how I'm going to get there. And then you say, I want to be a dentist. Oh, but where's the money going to come from? What's this? And then you, so you got two energies pulling two different ways. That's called the tug of war. That means you go nowhere. You're stuck right here because you're going here and here. You got to decide what you want to do. You have to decide. And many people don't. And Esther's saying absolutely. And painting is magic.
Painting is magic.
It definitely is. It definitely is. Yeah.
Yes.
So, so let's get started here. So tell me, what initially inspired you to pursue art, and how has your role as a mother, a wife, and a muralist influenced you in your creative process?
Okay. Well, I'm not a mother.
You sure ain't nothing about to happen? Because I usually don't say stuff like that and something ain't happening. You sure you ain't got no news for us?
I don't think so.
DACA.
Scratch the mother part.
That will happen soon. Yeah, what was the question? How did I get started?
You forgot the question. I had asked you, like, as a mother. She's like, wait a minute. Oh, what initially inspired you to pursue art? And how is that affecting now the family without the child?
Yes. Well, okay. I have to say my husband and my family, my family, my in-laws, everyone has just been super supportive of me and my journey, which is huge leg up, I think. But in 2019, right before the pandemic, I started selling my art for the first time. And I had a friend that was doing a lot of craft fairs, and she was like, you should come set up a table. And that's how I started doing that. I realized, you know, hey, this is really fun. I really like this. And it seems like people like my stuff too. So this is cool. But it was not my intention to leave my day job to pursue art. You know, it really was not my intention. And at the end of 2019, I turned 30, and I midlife crisis of like, I don't feel like I'm doing what I'm supposed to be doing. I really love helping people. I really love helping people, and I love making people feel good in their own skin. But the day-to-day of being in the fitness world really was feeling uncomfortable for me. It wasn't feeling like me anymore. And and then when the pandemic hit, you know, my gym closed down, and my boss actually at the time, he was like, I think you should take this plunge. I think you should, like, you know, go for this this art thing, you know, and you know, if not now, when? And it really was the nudge I needed to just go full force. And I really started off my art journey, my art business journey, I'd say, off of sheer enthusiasm. Like, I just went for it. And I didn't have a plan. I didn't think too heavily about what's this gonna look like? Oh, this isn't good enough. I just shared everything. And I have to say that is one of my favorite parts of being an artist, to really tell people journey, and because that's what's inspiring to me. I like watching and listening to the scrappy beginnings of people, you know, like once people are established and they're like big news, like,
yes,
it's not so interesting anymore. Yeah, like, I don't know what happened in the beginning. Like, what did you do to persevere through all of the challenges that you faced, and how did you overcome those obstacles? Mm-hmm. I love it. And I feel like bringing people in on that journey, which is super vulnerable and like sticky. Like, I just there's so much magic there, you know, because it's just real. It's so real. Mm-hmm. And I just kind of went off at it, you know, and from there, I've just kind of dabbled with all different types of mediums, and I don't limit myself to to a medium, you know. One of my artist mentors had mentioned that very early on. She was like, don't box yourself in, you know, because you might need to do sculpture in order to, you know, help your painting, or want to do this and that. And, So I think that was one of the best pieces of advice getting started. That's not, you know, really let the creativity be the guide and not the medium itself.
Yeah, and because you can get stuck in and get like pigeonholed into a certain type of thing. Like me, I like to do a variety of things too. And I just build an 8 foot wide by 8 feet high, 4 foot deep puppet booth and taught puppet making classes at the Arts Council of Princeton. So, you know, so having fun. A few disciplines is okay. Like I said, you know, so that's really great. And like I said, again, we talk ourselves out of a lot of stuff. And Esther Miller has a comment here. She's saying, you will feel it.
Mm-hmm.
And it's when you know it, you know it. And like I said, you have to make the decision and decide to keep going. And like Esther says here also, is have faith, you know, just continue to have faith in yourself and your abilities. And a lot of people don't have, you know, they're going into it, even questioning their own desires. So I'm glad you got past that. You know, bit of a hurdle
every day. So, I self-sabotage all the time. I mean, just last week I was just having a day and like five of the clay pots that I've made, I just threw them on the floor, just destroyed.
Wow.
Know? But it's just like, that's, to me, it's a part of the process. Do I really want it to be something that I hold on to? And I do in the future. No, it's something I'm working on, you know, but I am learning how to forgive myself and to trust that the self-sabotage is a part of the process to a certain extent. Like, you have to go through it.
Now, I know you all that's been listening, you want to see what she does, but just imagine if this was your daughter and she did your shed like this. Beautiful. Oh my God, that's freaking amazing. Esther's on here like, wow. And it is awesome that I'm telling you, it is so beautiful that's doing that. There was an old singer, Sylvester, and he used to have Martha and I Zora on there. He would be singing and he would be like, and then he would introduce to me, say, these women can sing, y'all. They don't need the dresses, the jewelries. These women can sing. Well, let me tell you something. This woman can paint. This woman right here can paint. And Esther said, it's beautiful.
Thank you.
Yes. And Mary, how you doing, Mary? It's good to hear. Hey, Mary, listen, I'm reaching out to you, Mary. Don't think I'm not. I had a talk with Mary on the phone, but she caught me at a very busy time. And don't worry, I'm calling you back. Thanks for tuning in, Mary. Yes. So let me get to my next question. So you mentioned something about, I think in your bio, the New Jersey Arts Council. Can you describe like your involvement with them or and how has it impacted your artistic journey? Was there something on here about the New Jersey Arts Council? I'm not sure if I saw it here. Maybe I didn't.
I don't know about that. I don't know. Okay. So, they're a New Jersey Arts Council.
Listen, I'm trying to tell you, I wrote the note down here for something. I don't know if I was going to put on here, but let me ask you something. Can you share like some insight into your like creative process? Like, what does that go from? Like, because you're doing different things. So, for example, when you're painting, like doing actual paintings, like what is your creative process and how does that differ from doing the sculptures and other things?
Well, it's kind of the same, to be honest. I'm a big journaler, and meditation and yoga are a big part of my practice. And I also pull like oracle cards, which are kind of like tarot cards. So that's kind of a big part of my creative practice. I usually start with, you know, having some type of ceremony for myself where like I light a candle and I'll set some intentions. That doesn't always happen. Sometimes I just like do some movement or shake it out, you know, have like a quick ceremony for myself. Sometimes I'll have like, you know, a 10-minute meditation where I'll just practice some breathing. But there's always some centering involved before I get started. And that's here in my studio, regardless what I'm working on. But it's also like, if I'm on a job site, like I'll find some space to center before I get started. That's a big part of the process. While I'm like in it, I just get into a flow state and I really just allow myself to kind of go off and something takes over and I'm just kind of doing my thing. And I mean, time is not relevant when I'm actually creating and nothing really matters in that particular moment. Like, but the centering helps me get there. And I like teaching people how to do that too. I have a workshop coming up at the Hamilton Y. I don't have a date yet.
Awesome.
I don't have a date yet, but it's going to be about that. And we're going to be using meditation and yoga to kind of help us find our true selves, really help us tap into ourselves and then create from that space. So that's going to be.
Speaking of that, folks, so that you can get that information, this is Rebecca's email address, and you also want to check out her website, and on Facebook, Rebecca Eve Swan, and her IG is Rebecca Eve _ Swan. So I'll put these back up again for you all, you know, throughout the show, but like I said, you know, you can find out when those workshops are by just, you know, making sure you follow her and hit the notification bells and everything you have to in order to be updated, start following her to get her content on a regular. So I'm going to put up a few of your images and I want to show some of the work and then you can tell me and what you like to about each one of these pieces I'm going to put up. So video, I'm teasing you with that. I didn't want to show that video. No. Listen, let me tell you something. Do I have my background music on? It is my background music overpowering? I hope it's not, everybody.
It's good.
You can hear me good. So let me get some of her art up here and then you can let us know where you want to go here.
That's my favorite painting.
Tell us about this one.
Yeah, this was one of my first ones getting started at the beginning of 2020. I made this. A lot of art poured out of me at that time. Like I really, I said, I kind of got going. Still trying to figure this one out, but it came to me in a dream. And the next day I had to paint it and I got started and I just kind of kept working on it. But to me, I have this like story that goes with it. And there's like a full moon in the back. And the story goes that on the full moon of each month, this treehouse appears on this like secret lake. And you have to kayak blindly into this lake, just kind of like, you know, hoping to receive the magic. And, you know, maybe it shows itself to you, maybe it doesn't.
This is beautiful. This is absolutely beautiful.
Yeah. But I'm still trying to figure it out. I really love it. I don't know. It's very me, I think.
Awesome. Let's look at this next one.
Yeah.
So this right here, what this was something you done. Now, is that on the wall or is it thing or is that all? Everything is the painting. Like what? I'm trying to look. I ain't got my reading glass on. I can't even see that.
Yeah. So it's a faux brick wall that they had, and I painted on top of that. This was a commercial mural that I did at Taco Rio. This is the Plainsboro location. I also painted their Pikestown location.
That wow, was like, that's beautiful.
No, well, second maybe. But I love this mural. And they just wanted to, you know, like those were their characters. And I kind of, you know, I don't flare on them. But they kind of wanted them to be like a low rider car, and they wanted like graffiti style fonts. And I just really had fun with that. And along the whole restaurant, there's, you know, more cacti and like chili peppers, just kind of along the soffits of the space. And yeah, it's really, really fun. I really love doing.
Yeah, that's really fun for any space there. Yeah, Esther Miller saying, nice. You see, I'm telling you, I already told you, your work is amazing. It definitely is. Let me show you another piece here. I think this is... Now, where was this at?
What?
Now, where is... This is your... Now, what is this place right here? This is your location?
This is a grooming salon. A grooming place. Dogs. And... this is a window painting, which I do usually like seasonal, like around the holiday times. I'll do like snowy trees and things like that. But these guys wanted like a summer painting on their window. Gotcha. And I'll tell you, they love it so much that it's still there today. I did it like two and a half years ago, that painting. And
I would leave it up.
I am shocked that it
actually wouldn't be.
Because it's a window painting, like usually it's pretty temporary, but they have that overhang, so that's not going anywhere unless they want it to.
Nope.
But
that painting have to fall off for me.
yeah, they love it so much, and just talking about like connecting with like spirit or you know the universe or whatever. The dog that's under the umbrella on the right there. The owners had left the space, and they came back when I was finishing up, and they were like, oh my gosh, it's Bubby. And I'm thinking, Bubby was my grandmother. And I'm like, what are you talking? And they're like, Bubby was our dog. How did you know? She's just like that. And I had no idea. This was just what came to me. I felt it. And I just love that part of the creation process also, like just being open to receive these messages that you cannot even understand. And you really light people up. And I love, like, that's what I love about commissions, you know, like I'm able to connect with people on a level beyond words.
Yes.
And it's, so this was a really fun window. It's one of my favorite windows. It's hard. I mean, everything you're going to pull up here is going to be my favorite.
Going back to this, here we go. These right here. Yes. This is some of, now, tell us about these pieces.
These are new. They're little vases. They're little vases. And I just like them. I just think they're kind of cool. You know, the ceramics is pretty new to me. In high school, I was really into ceramics. Very much into it. So it's been fun to kind of get back into it. But the vases are really great. I've also been dabbling with flower arrangements just for myself. Just like as a hobby to have like fresh cut flowers, and I was like, you know, having like vases around could be really fun. So I made them.
Hey, I totally get it. These are beautiful, man. I mean, they would look. I mean, I would love to have one of those in my house. Hey, listen, we have Esther asking, are they for sale?
They are for sale. They are for sale. I think they start around like $17. They're not very expensive.
$17?
They're like $17, I think. And they're on my website, RebeccaSwanArt.com. And I think that list.
I'm going to put the website back up for you, Esther. And she says they start at $17. So let me put it up here so you can make sure you get her website. I'm going to leave it up for a little bit.
Yeah.
So we're going to go on to the next piece. Go right here. The old man gets around a computer pretty good now.
it's also my favorite. Everything's my favorite. I just love it. I mean, I really love the colors of this one. And
A lot of times artists don't make their originals in this shape, in that really like more narrow land. I love doing paintings like that. I'm like doing like four right now, but like that is a shape that I just don't see often, you know, that artists don't really, you know, do that. I mean, I've seen people with it, but you tend to see the more you know, your standard, what consider standard sizes, you know.
Oh yeah.
But I've seen people paint like this. But go ahead, I'm sorry.
Yeah. I'll paint on anything. It doesn't matter. Like, you know, give me a piece of scrap wood and I'll paint on that. I mean, it really doesn't matter. I'm really not snooty about my materials at all.
Yeah.
Something with color, give me a surface, I'm good to go.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I think I actually painted over something else. It was sitting in my basement, I think. And I was like, you know, I need a canvas. And I think something like that composition, I was seeing it in a dream. Or a meditation. I knew I wanted something tall and narrow. And
It's stunning. It's absolutely stunning. So, and what is that on? What's it on again?
This is acrylic on canvas. And okay. I sell the prints of my work too. So yes. This one is a print too. But that's the frustrating thing about the irregular sizes. Because the regular sizes are more expensive than standard sizes. So I hate that about it, you know?
Yeah.
I just want everyone to be able to have it.
Yeah. I've gotten like you know, I try to make my own stretcher boards and canvas and everything. I like get the canvas in a roll and then I cut and make the custom size, especially when you get the larger ones over like 48 by 60, you got to really kind of make it yourself, or order stretcher boards. I'll make them and then do
That's
it.
Great.
So you can make them to do odd sizes, but I like taking on panels as well. So it's really exciting using the different materials, and we're basically recycling the materials as well. So listen, this is the part of the show where I have to do my shameless advertisement, where I get run one of my little shameless commercials here and to promote you know, some of my artwork. So I'm sorry about this little shameless ad I'm about to put on. We'll be right back. Okay. This is funny because I said I know how to work myself around a computer. And my computer is like going slower. So it's one step behind every button I hit. So I hit the button, but something else slipped up underneath it. So let me just be slow. See how it keeps going there? There's like, it is actually, I'm telling you, there's a delay every time I hit this button. Technical difficulties here, women and ladies and gentlemen. And what I'm going to do is edit this out when I do the rebroadcast.
While we proudly showcase the original artwork of artist Kenneth J. Lewis Sr., we also offer an array of other products to complement your artistic interests. From charming coffee mugs and elegant note cards to stunning prints and captivating published books, there's something for everyone to enjoy. Be sure to explore our diverse selection. As a token of appreciation, we're delighted to offer you a special discount. Simply click the link in the description and use promo code KJL10 at checkout to receive a generous 10% off your order. Plus, enjoy free shipping on orders totaling $50 or more. It's our way of saying thank you for supporting our passion for artistry. Start browsing now and enhance your collection with our unique offerings. We can't wait to see what catches your eye. Hashtag grateful, hashtag much love.
Okay, we're back. After we got finished with all that drama I had before I ran to our commercial.
No, it's great. Your work is amazing. So
cool. Oh, thank you. But we're like family here. So every now and then your family, somebody knocks over, you know, drink on the table and, you know, the dog runs through something or, you know. That's right. So this is what's happening here. You know, little glitches here and there. We're going to leave it natural. you know what? You mentioned prints, and I was actually kind of the next question I was going to run to you and say, I know you do prints, but how do you feel you maintain the integrity of your work? You know, do you think it makes it, you'd like to make it more accessible to a wider audience? Do you make prints of all of your work, or are there some things that are exclusive? Do you do limited editions? Like, how do you go about that? Or you just will print anything?
So when I got started, yeah, I was printing everything. Like, someone was like, I like that. And I would just photograph it and make a print. I'm really in the process of narrowing that down and kind of curating it a little bit more. And I have to outsource my prints. I don't print them here in-house. So I've been kind of...
I'm having a little bit of trouble hearing you. I'm having a little bit of trouble. It was a little bit of an echo. I was having a little bit of trouble hearing you.
Okay. How about now?
Yeah. Can you turn your volume up just a little bit? All right. Go ahead.
Okay.
Go ahead. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
It's better. I hope it's better. I don't have any other tools.
Yeah, I can hear you. But go ahead.
Yeah. So I've been kind of trying to figure out what the best way to go about doing that is. There is a printer that I like to use, but they're, you know, it's fine art prints, so there's like, it's top quality paper and it's expensive, you know, which would mean I have to charge like $50 for, you know,
exactly,
print. So what I'm trying to do, I did find a printer that's really inexpensive. And I'm gonna submit an order, and I'm gonna see how they are. You know, I just want to see what the quality is, because I'm now in this approach of wanting my prints to be like an entry level kind of offer for people. You know, I want it to be accessible for everybody. You know, I want people to be able to be like, oh, I can spend $20 on a print. You know, I really. I'm very much interested in creating a market for, you know, gifting, you know, for yourself or for others. I really am very passionate about that. You know, and it's because those are my people, you know, it's people I know and I love. Like, I don't know a lot of people that are, you know, wanting or have the resources to just drop, you know, $100 just because, you know. I'm really on this mission to be able to offer prints, especially like prints specifically, at a lower cost, and you know, using that as my entry to, you know, gain a bigger following, to see who my people really are and what my audience is. And some of those people will come back and they'll buy more prints, or they'll commission me to do something different. I'm figuring that out right now, but it's tough because it is expensive to print things, and you want the quality to be good. So, you know, I don't know how much of a paper snob I am, but the image has to look good. You know, the color has to be good. It can't be grainy, you know. Yeah. So I do have some standards. So I'm kind of curious to see how this other company is going to.
Mm-hmm. Well, I have some information for you, and I'll share it, you know, offline with you, because there are quite a few print companies out there, and you know, I sell the prints as well, and note cards, all that stuff. So I'll give you an idea how to,
share, that
know,
be
some
super
information, and I'll just like, I'll email you, or we'll talk later, and I'll give it to you. So, 'cause I'm not sure who you use it, but we can go deeper into that later.
Yeah, I love that. That would be great.
Let me ask you something. What do you hope that people that are viewing your art, like, what do you hope they take away from that? When they see your art, like, what is it you want them to take away? How do you want them to feel?
I want them to feel uplifted. I want them to feel uplifted. I want them to feel a sense of wonder and a sense of hope. I really want people to kind of see my art and be like, it's like kind of a breath of fresh air, kind of like, it's going to be okay. Like, I can do it. Or like it's going to be okay. I just want to create more joy in the world and more wonder. I think wonder is a big part of it, you know, to to kind of captivate people's imaginations. I really don't think there's enough of that. I think we all need to exercise our imaginations a little bit more. Yeah.
Beautiful. This part we're coming to in the episode is the artist that kind of inspired you. And you had two of them. You had Frida Kahlo and you had Iris, I hope I'm pronouncing it right, Apfel. And, you know, so I didn't know this artist. And so what I did was I did a little bit of research on her. And this is Iris Apfel. And she's freaking amazing. Let me tell you about this woman right here. Look at this woman right here. Let me tell you about her. Isn't it like, have you ever seen, I think she lived till, I think she was 102. And she passed and went not too long ago. In,
it was this March, the beginning of the month, she passed.
Yes. So she just not too long ago died. And she's amazing. Let me tell you a little bit about her. Iris Apfel is a renowned American businesswoman, interior designer, and fashion icon known for her eclectic personal style. The thing that me and you have, that eclectic thing. And distinctive oversized glasses. Born on August 29th, 1921 in Astoria, Queens, New York City, she gained widespread recognition later in life for her unique fashion sense, which celebrates individuality and creativity. Apfel's career in fashion began in the 1950s when she and her husband, Carl Apfel, founded Old World Weavers, a textile company that specialized in reproducing historic fabric patterns for clients such as the White House. Through her work in interior design, Apfel developed a keen sense of textiles, colors, and patterns. Let me pull this one thing up here really quick. Look at this amazing dress she has on here, which generally influenced her personal style. In 2005, at the age of 84, Iris Apfel gained recognition. I lost my track on here. Gained mainstream attention after the Metropolitan Museum of Art in New York City featuring an exhibition of her clothing and accessories titled Rara Avis, Selections from the Iris Collection. The exhibition showcased her vast collection of culture, clothing, accessories, jewelry, and highlighting her distinctive avant-garde taste in fashion. Following the success of the exhibition, Apfel became a fashion icon known for her bold and fearless approach to style. She was, thank you, see, this what happened. The subject of the 2014 documentary film Iris, directed by Albert Maysels, which offered an intimate look into her life and career. Documentary further solidified her status as a fashion icon and cultural phenomenon. Despite her advanced age, Iris Apfel remained active in the fashion industry, collaborating with various brands and designers. She continues to inspire people of all ages to embrace their individuality and creativity through fashion and personal style. Apfel's impact extends beyond the realm of fashion as she serves as a role model for aging with grace, vitality, and a zest for life. What amazing and what a wonderful person to be inspired by. That lady is absolutely amazing. I knew nothing of her until you told me. And so, you know, front man does his research. And we got here, we got you showing the love for her, and then we got Esther saying rest in peace. Yes. Because this just amazing. I sat here and I like it was like an hour. I was like reading the stuff about her and looking at her things and like, I'm so glad you introduced me to her because I also looked at some of her fashion and I was like, as far as her stuff that I can incorporate, that's some of the colorful stuff she had in just some of my art. So I appreciate
it. Oh, yeah. She was just so bold. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
So tell me a little bit so tell me your thoughts on her, you know, because that's the artist you felt. And
it's her way about doing things is incredibly inspiring to me. I mean, talk about doing whatever the heck you want to do and really living into your truth. I mean, that's what she did. And she, you know, people would say like, that, does that go together? What are you talking? And she was like, well, yeah, like, you know, and she was funny about it too. And she really lived into that, and leaned into that, you know, that knowing that this is her. And this is, and I just, I really, I love that. I love when people are just unapologetically themselves. And,
yes. And like you said, like, I see that same like type of free flowing energy with all of the work that I've seen you do. And speaking of that, we're going to show another one of your videos, and then we're going to take a look at your the other artist that inspires you, Frida Kahlo, and just tell you a little bit about Frida Kahlo. So let me get moving here, and we're going to look at our next clip that you got here. I don't want to put a rerun on. Awesome.
Those are my mushrooms.
Yes, yes. Okay, so we have the next female artist that inspires you. And it's one of my daughter's favorite artists, and it's Frida Kahlo. And so I'll give you a short little history on Frida Kahlo. Frida Kahlo was a Mexican artist known for her striking self-portraits and her association with surrealism. I'm going to get here so I can show you the other picture. Born on July 6, 1907, I'm going to mess this up, Coyoacan, Mexico City, Kahlo's life was marked by physical and emotional pain. At the age of 6, she contracted polio, which left her right leg permanently weakened. Then at 18, she suffered a severe bus accident that resulted in numerous injuries, leading to a lifetime of chronic pain and medical complications. During her recovery from the accident, Kahlo began painting, using a mirror mounted above her bed to create her iconic self-portrait. Her paintings often depict her physical and emotional suffering, as well as themes of identity, gender, and Mexican culture. Kahlo's style was characterized by vibrant colors, symbolism, and intricate detail. Throughout her career, Kahlo's work gained recognition both in Mexico and internationally. However, she struggled for widespread acceptance during her lifetime, overshadowed by the success of her husband, the muralist Diego Rivera. Despite this, Kahlo's art has since become celebrated for its deeply personal and introspective nature. Kahlo's life was marked by tumultuous relationships, including her marriage to Rivera, which was characterized by infidelity and mutual passion. Despite their difficulties, Kahlo and Rivera remained married until Kahlo's death. Frida Kahlo's legacy extends beyond her art. She is revered as a feminist icon and a symbol of Mexican cultural identity. Her unapologetically embrace of her physical disabilities and her defiance of social norms continue to inspire artists and activists around the world. Kahlo's home is in Coyoacan, known as Casa Azul, Blue House, has been preserved as a museum dedicated to her life and work. It remains a popular destination for visitors seeking to learn more about this iconic artist. And got another picture here of Frida Kahlo. And you can see here, like, they talk about, like, she was in a lot of, you know, just amazing story. I saw the documentary on her, and it's amazing, like, that she was able to just keep creating and it, you know, with the pain that she was in. So tell me, what about Frida is it that, you know,
resonates? A lot of things, but her strength. You know, I mean, I don't know if I could, if I would be able to continue on with all of the things that she has gone through at such a young age. I mean, talk about perseverance, you know,
yes.
And strength, you know? So when I think Frida Kahlo, I think strength. And, the other thing that I really just love about her and her story and her work is her vulnerability, her ability to put so much of herself in her work is very inspiring to me. I mean, like I said earlier, the vulnerability thing is just, it's such a big piece of it. It's such a big piece of, you know, and the journey to the self. The journey to the self is such a big part of my creative process. And she embodied that, you know, I mean, that's what it was, you know? Yeah. And then on top of that, just her connection to surrealism is very influential to me. And it, you know, cause I'm inspired by that too. Like I'm inspired by my dreams and my visions and things like that. And I see that in her surrealist style work, you know, and the colors, like there's so much about Frida Kahlo, you know, so much.
And could you imagine just laying there in the bed, you've been in a bus accident, you already have polio, you already have it. And then you have to lay her in the bed with a mirror above you and you're painting these fabulous paintings, like amazing paintings. But that's a gift from God. I don't care what anybody says. God just totally blessed you. Even in the midst of what you deem is painful, and look at the beauty that she spread around the world and the people that she's inspired. She's my daughter's favorite artist. When they had the exhibition in Philadelphia, my daughter went there. She was like, I'm going to this, you know, exhibition. I forget where, I'm not sure if it was a Philadelphia Museum. I don't think it was the Barnes Foundation. I think it was the Philadelphia Museum. She went there and this is her favorite artist. She brought me back. I forget what she brought me back. Was a print. Yeah, I think it was a print. She bought that. So, yeah, one of my daughter's favorites too. Okay.
Yeah. She's great.
So, is there anything you want to share with us that we need to know about you? And like, tell us, like, you know, tell us how we can get in contact with you. But tell us about all of the services and things that you offer. You know?
I offer a lot of things. I don't even know where to start. I really don't. I'm kind of lost for words.
Sell prints, like you do murals, like try to narrow down as best, like to give them all the different things that you do in case anyone's interested. They may not think you're just a muralist. It is so. Yeah.
Right. So yes, I do murals for commercial spaces, but also residential spaces like the sheds. Okay. Big fan of shed paintings. If you have a shed, call me, please.
Awesome.
But also, you know, I like to make stuff and I like to sell things, and those things kind of change. So I've been on this like mushroom kind of inspiration journey for a few years now. Hold on a second. Let me get a planter for you to see. So this is one of my planters, by the way.
Wow.
Picture. I'm trying to figure out. Okay. So this is a little planter stake. And they sit in your little potted plants. And it's a shroom. I call them shroom buddies. So they're just kind of fun. So like I have like little stuff that I really like to sell as like gifts and things that I would do at like craft fairs and things like that. But also commission work. You know, I do a lot of commission work that I haven't really shared a lot of the commission work because they are just so deeply personal. I think there's another picture that you might have of mine of a barn door.
Okay, let's go down here and listen. As a matter of fact, while you're talking, I am going to do just that. I'm going to pull up. I don't know why I left this darn Frida Kahlo picture up here so long. And we're steady talking like Frida's in the conversation. But hey, Frida, what's up?
She's here.
She's right in the conversation. All right, let's get back to this. We're going to come back up here. So I think that's the last one I showed. So I had this one.
Yeah, so that's a painting. That one's really small, actually, 8x10. But keep going. There's one that I was thinking about. I think I sent it to you. No, that's the shed. That's the shed. Those are my little rabbits. Ooh, I don't know if I sent it to you then.
Yeah, no, I don't see any. Then I see this. This is the other one. This is it. Let me look at the top. I'm looking up here. I had to store it. Yeah, that's it. There was no, okay. I don't have another one.
All right. Well, you'll have to go to my website, I guess, to find that. Okay. But basically for my commissions, I like people to tell me like what they're looking to feel or what they want to kind of, yeah, really what they want to feel with a painting. And based on that, I create. So this picture that I'm thinking in my head, my client wanted, you know, there were some symbols that she really wanted in the painting, like a blue heron and a lion, and she wanted it to say, trust the universe. And I created this huge barn door for her. And again, it goes back to that connection that I was able to kind of create and feel with her without words. She just kind of gave me a few prompts, and then I created this thing that neither one of us really even could have imagined. So I really like doing the commissions like that, where we can kind of go deep and figure out, you know, like how, like, what is it that you really want to feel, you know, through this work. The picture that you have right now, that's a cute illustration, and I do those for commissions too. This here actually for my grandpa, because he loves penguins and he's a golfer and he always wears a cap like that, always. So I like doing things like that too. I think that's really fun.
Yeah, that's cool.
But
that is,
I mean,
cool, that little piece.
Yeah.
And you had this one wall here that I put up. Like that was the shed you did for, is that the shed, right?
That's the shed that we saw.
Oh my God, that it looks so beautiful. I mean, like, you could do anything, like set design, backdrops or plays, anything. Like, yeah, so this is very beautiful.
Yeah.
So we have a hello from Malibu Ken.
Yeah.
Saying hello, everyone. Hello, Malibu Ken. And then we have Jody Liebman on here sending a heart. We're sending love back at you. Send love back at you. We're going to look at another one of your short little videos on here. So this is the third video I have. And so let me get that up here.
Swimming, just keep swimming, just keep swimming, 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 just keep swimming, just keep swimming, just keep swimming, 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 just keep swimming, just keep swimming, just keep swimming, 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 just keep swimming, just keep swimming, just keep swimming, swimming, swimming.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
Thank
That's
you.
Absolutely beautiful. I'm putting your information up here again. So again, remember to follow Rebecca. Her email address is RebeccaEveSwan@gmail.com. RebeccaEveSwan.com is her website. And she's on Facebook, Rebecca Eve Swan on Facebook, on IG. It's RebeccaEve_Swan on IG. Make sure you follow her. Keep updated on all of her progress as an artist. Again, she's a very, very amazing artist. Let me ask you, this is our last question we have for you. And I've asked all my guests, what is your, do you have any advice for young and up and coming artists?
I do. Because I still think that I'm an up and coming artist.
Absolutely.
No, I think my best advice is to just create as much as you possibly can. Don't stop. You know, really create a practice for yourself and find a way to just make something or feel creative every day. Even if you don't get into the studio, go cook something. Go out in the garden. Like, go find inspiration. Go for a walk in nature and pick something up off the ground that inspires you, like an acorn or a pine cone or whatever it is. Find things that inspire you and never lose your sense of wonder. Just go.
Absolutely.
And don't get in your way, you know, like find things that, you know, help you center, to help you shut out the noise that gets in your way, because we are our own worst critics, and we can be so mean to ourselves. Mm-hmm. Like the things that I say to myself, I would never say to anybody ever, you know? Uh-huh. And I think it's really important to create grounding practices that can help you work through that noise. Because if you can work through that noise through mm-hmm. creating or through going out for a walk in nature or whatever it is, cooking a meal, whatever your outlet may be, you just have to keep going. You just have to keep, you know, just keep moving, keep swimming, just like that song. keep swimming. Gosh. Yeah.
And like you said, like sometimes we just self-sabotage ourselves. We talk in the opposite direction of the things we want. Instead of speaking affirmatively to ourselves, we speak negatively to ourselves and we beat ourselves up. Newsflash, nobody's perfect. Newsflash, everybody makes mistakes. Newsflash, everyone needs some time to have someone, you know, or some type of guidance and grace and mercy and love. So it's like, you just gotta, like you said, you have to keep pushing forward. You have to keep going in the direction of what you want. And, you know, we always come to fork in the roads. We have to go this way or that way. And sometimes we go the right way. Sometimes we can end up veering off and like, oh, this is another. But the beautiful thing, just like GPS, your spirit is like that. You know, even though I'm riding on the road and you get off course, the GPS says, oh, you're going the wrong way. But now let me show you how to get to where you want to go from here. So you can get off course. But there's always, you can still start from that point and find the shortest distance to get it from there. So, awesome. Listen, thank you so much for coming on. I really appreciate you. Thank you for sharing, you know, part of your artistic journey. We love it. We're going to follow you. I've been following you. And, you know, really, really much love.
Yeah, thank you for having me. It was really fun. And I'm looking forward to, you know, doing more things together for collaborating. Awesome. Or whatever.
Yes. We're going to do that big collab, I'm telling you. Yeah.
Yeah.
So, I'm excited.
And maybe getting to know some of the people that have been in the chat. Thank you so much for chiming in.
Absolutely. Remember, you guys, just don't chime in. Follow her. You saw it. I'm going to put it up here one more time so that you can know. This is our email address. Oh, that's mine. Sorry. shameless. All right. There's our email address, website. Give me enough time to write it down. And you can look at the rebroadcast too. Facebook and IG.
Yeah. I'm definitely the most active on Instagram, I would say.
Okay.
Facebook. I'm still trying to figure that out. It gives me a hard time sometimes.
Yeah, it's a good thing, but there's certain aspects you can use. And like I said, when I share the thing out with the print, I'll share some information on that too.
Awesome.
All right. Okay. Thank you so much for coming on, and you know, keep up your artistic journey. You're doing a wonderful job. You have a very bright future.
Thank you, Kenneth. Thanks for having me. Have a great day. Bye.
Bye. Wow, what a wonderful artist we had on here today. I'm like, these artist interviews, like I'm enjoying and getting to really connect and network with quite a few artists. We have quite a few artists lined up that are coming up in the future. Our next artist, by the way, was Mary Claggett. She has got a last minute exhibition, so we're gonna push her off, so I don't have the information. I'm filling one of the other artists in for next week, and Mary's date is going to be shipped. We're still going to interview Mary, but she had an opportunity to put some art at a location and make some, you know, money, so we're not gonna and she gave me enough notice in advance, so I don't have next week's artist, but we will have an artist that will be interviewing next week. And so let me do some of my shameless advertising, like I said. And at the last, let's go here. And what we're going to do is I'm going to put my advertisement video on here one more time. I'm going to share my social with you. Mm-hmm. I don't care. It's in real time.
While we proudly showcase the original artwork of artist Kenneth J. Lewis Sr., we also offer an array of other products to complement your artistic interests. From charming coffee mugs and elegant note cards to stunning prints and captivating published books, there's something for everyone to enjoy. Be sure to explore our diverse selection. As a token of appreciation, we're delighted to offer you a special discount. Simply click the link in the description and use promo code KJL10 at checkout to receive a generous 10% off your order. Plus, enjoy free shipping on orders totaling $50 or more. It's our way of saying thank you for supporting our passion for artistry. Start browsing now and enhance your collection with our unique offerings. We can't wait to see what catches your eye. Hashtag grateful, hashtag much love.
Awesome. So here we go. And let's see what we have here. As you can see, my ticker's going here. If you'd love to, any support that you give us is appreciated. You can donate to us, and you will receive, for your kind donations, you'll receive one of my logo mugs. It's 11 ounce coffee mug, microwave safe, and you will get one of these free. It's free shipping for any donation to the state, to my podcast channel. If you'd like to follow me, it's KJL Artists on Instagram. My YouTube channel, it's Kenneth J. Lewis on YouTube. And I also have KJL Podcast channel on YouTube. My website is KJLArtSanctuary.com. You can reach me at KJLArtSanctuary@gmail.com as well. And again, I am like so grateful for you tuning in today. And I'm looking forward to seeing you next Sunday with my artist interview. Please like, share, and subscribe to my YouTube channel and hit the notification bell so that you will be alerted when I upload new content live or upcoming. And again, thank you. I am so grateful and much love.